Now we have here in the next verse, and in all of these are remarkable verses, but these, now who are these? The certain men that crept in unawares, the apostates that have come into the church, but these speak evil of those things which they know not, but what they know naturally as brute beasts, in those things they corrupt themselves. Now I'd like, as best I can, to make this verse understandable to you, because it's another one of the important verses in this epistle. Now, to begin with, when he says these speak evil, the word in the Greek is blasphemio. And blasphemio, our English word by transliteration, is blaspheme. They actually blaspheme. These speak evil. They blaspheme those things which they know not, but that which they know naturally. Now, there are two different words used for know. And without knowing that, by the way, it's difficult to know exactly what Jude means here. Now, the first know is oida, and that speaks of mental comprehension and knowledge. And that's the meaning that Vincent gives. And it refers to the whole range of invisible things. You know, knowledge is not confined to what you pour in a test tube or look at under a microscope. A great many people think that is true. But actually, the finer things of life today are things you can't put under the microscope. You just can't pour them in a test tube. How about a wonderful piece of music today? What happens to it when you stick it down in the test tube or look at it under the microscope? May I say that it needs to be translated into sound, and the ear needs to hear it. You can't see it at all. It's actually invisible. Love is invisible. You couldn't put love under the microscope. How about faith? You can't put it under the microscope. My friends, there are a great many things I know, and I know it without any proof of taking it to the laboratory. Now, as Spurgeon put it, no one has to tell me that honey's sweet. I know that. There are a lot of things that I know and you know that you can't put under the test tube. And so that word here, they speak of that which they don't know. And this Washington preacher, he thought he was very brilliant by saying that he no longer believed in the resurrection. May I say to you that there are a lot of things he doesn't know, many things that he does not know. But now the next word is epistomai, and that means to understand. And Vincent says that it was originally use of skill and handicraft and refers to palpable things, objects of sense, the circumstances of sensual enjoyment. Now, here is where you pour things in the test tube. They only know what they can handle, what they can see. That is all that these folk know. This is the word that is here. And they're like brute beasts in those things, because after all, a brute beast only knows about the hay or the grass or the corn or another animal that it can eat. And that is that which they know by instinct. The ducks, you know, in the winter time when it's fall of the year, they're up in Canada. They're having a nice summer up there. And all of a sudden, they take off. Somebody says, boy, are they smart. Those ducks know that before long it'll be winter and that snow will be on the ground and the lake's going to freeze over, and they take off for the south. They go all the way down into Central America and to Mexico. They go down there. They're very smart. No, they're not. They just move just like a beast, just like a bird moves. There's no comprehension, no understanding. And this generation that thinks it's so smart today because it only believes what it can pour in a test tube is a poor generation. They don't understand anything that a brute beast couldn't understand. They have not reached the higher plane of knowledge of what Paul called epigenosko. Paul says you can know that the Bible is the Word of God. You can know that Jesus is the Savior of the world. Now, these, just knowing physical things, they think they know everything that can be known. They corrupt themselves. That's the picture of the apostates.